Joining us today is Colleen Noir. He's a lawyer and a Second Amendment rights advocate. Thank you so much for joining us today, Colleen.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
All right. Could you give us a little bit about your history and what brought you into being an influential voice in the Second Amendment community?
I would like to say that my process in becoming a second rights advocate has been is probably about as organic as it comes. I didn't grow up in a house that was pro-gun. I didn't grow up in a house with firearms. And I didn't shoot my first gun until I was about 23, 24-ish. And what essentially happened was I had a good friend of mine who asked me if I wanted to go to the range one day. And I said, you know, not so much. Not really a fan of that idea. I'm sorry, my AC's going crazy. I said I really wasn't a fan of firearms. I wasn't against them, so to speak, but I just wasn't the biggest fan of them. But I decided, what the hell, let me go ahead and go. I went to the range, shot the gun for the first time, and fell in love. And within that month, I think I bought 4 firearms. And then I started actually making firearm videos on YouTube. And as I started to do that, I started to get more involved with the political side of the discussion with respect to firearms. And I started making political commentary about my thoughts and opinions on different issues revolving around firearms, as well as some of the political discussions that were taking place on the national level. And those videos started going viral. I started making more of those videos. And then at a certain point, I got pretty big, and I developed a pretty big following, big enough that it caught the attention of the NRA. The NRA reached out to me and asked me if I wanted to do some work with them as far as being an advocate through their platform. And I did that. Throughout that process, I went ahead and while I was with the NRA, had my own show called Noir, which was pretty much a firearms lifestyle culture show where we went around the country talking to different people in the firearm community, but also addressing socio-political issues, say, for instance, the heroin epidemic in places like Seattle, the homelessness issues in places like San Francisco, so forth and so on.
So why do you think the gun issue has become so partisan now, with one side being pro-gun rights and the other side coming up with really strict gun control laws?
For me, largely, and I just tweeted this out not too long ago, that for the longest time, when I talked about 2A political issues and just a conversation about the gun debate in this country, I tried to remain nonpartisan. I tried to avoid using words like the Democrats or the Republicans, and even to a certain extent, the left or the right. However, over the times that I've been doing this, and it's about 15 years now, I've realized there's one consistent theme here, and I can't ignore it, is that by and large, the vast majority of the political left leadership, specifically the Democrats, have been anti-gun. And by, what I mean by anti-gun is pushing legislation to further restrict the rights under the Second Amendment. What they've managed to do was take the idea of firearm ownership in one breath and say, the only people who practice this right are white people. And those white people are racist and they don't want black people to have firearms. So ironically enough, their solution to this is let's ban guns. And so what has happened with the result of that is then you have the right who's like, well, no, we have these constitutional freedoms. And then the right, generally speaking, not being very fond of big government, it's looking at them and saying, no, well, we want the freedoms that the Second Amendment affords. It's an inalienable right. It's our natural right. Whereas the left and the Democrats, and I'm speaking specifically in terms of the leadership, they are generally speaking look very favorably on big government. And what does big government usually like to do is I like to say they're a black hole for more power and control. That's generally what they're looking for, is to create as much dependency by way of us on them as possible. And what is the best way to do that? Well, make it so that my ability to protect myself is dependent on the government. And you do that by taking away my right to own a firearm that would allow me to defend myself. And so what has happened is they created this line of demarcation that says, well, if you're a Democrat and you're left-leaning, but you are in favor of firearms, you're not really a Democrat. You're actually a right-wing radical conservative and a racist, right? Or if you're a black person who espouses the Second Amendment, you are seen as a traitor to your race because you're not falling in line with the Democratic belief system. And so that's essentially why this whole issue about firearms, which I think should not be partisan, has become partisan.
That That's very true. And now it's almost impossible to have a sensible discussion now, because it's almost as though if you take, you can't even be in the middle anymore. It's like you're either this or you're that, and there's no middle ground almost.
Yeah, and I think the reason why that is in a lot of ways too is because if you look at the right, and when I say the right, I mean the Second Amendment, it states very explicitly, shall not be infringed. Right now on the federal level, we have over 300 gun control laws. On the local level, state and local level, we have over 20,000. I think we've kind of more than infringed on the right at this point. And so what has happened now, we're at a weird kind of stalemate where we don't want any, not only do we not want any more gun control laws, we also want some of the stuff that we lost back. Whereas on the other side, their only solution is to further restrict the right more and more and more. And if you don't agree with any of those measures, then you're seen as unreasonable, and therefore you're seen as extreme. And so, and on the other side, we're like, well, no, we don't want anything. No more gun control laws. We're past the point of reasonableness at this point. And not only that, we'd like some of our gun control laws back. So we're kind of almost at a political cold war in a sense, where one side wants to keep restricting further and we're like, no, no more restrictions. And then we want some of our rights back. And so now it's kind of hard to, that middle ground is very slender, very, very, very slender. But you brought up a good point too, as well as we can't even have the conversation at this point because it's always taken to the furthest extremes possible. And that's largely who dominates the conversation on the public level.